The use of UV light for sanitizing or sterilizing personal items is a method that is actually endorsed by the CDC. There are many UV light products on the market that claim to provide germicidal benefits, but the light output and exposure time suggested by the CDC to deactivate COVID-19 are not practical for many of them. There are also a great many UV light products that are just outright fakes. The question is, with something that is this important to your health, how do you know if the UV light you have is real? Stick around for this video, and we'll help you to get a handle on things. And don't forget to like and subscribe so we can continue to bring you important content like this. The CDC and the International Ultraviolet Association provide good information and a few guidelines on the subject of UVC germicidal light used for deactivating COVID-19 and other things. We will present ideas that are derived from that information for you and show you how to comply with the guidelines, as well as how to verify that your UV light is actually one that operates within the germicidal light spectrum. For this video, we'll be using a UV light box that we made from a toaster oven. Check the end of this video for a link on how to build one just like this of your very own. Or you may be able to buy a light box like this one on eBay. This light box started life as a Black & Decker toaster oven, and it has a built-in timer. The temperature control dial is disabled since we don't need it. There is a wire rack for setting your items on, and most importantly, it has a 15-watt mercury vapor light bulb that emits light in the UVC spectrum. There are a few ways to verify that your light is actually germicidal, and to also quantify the output of the light. A dosimeter card is by far the cheapest and the easiest to use. We got these ones from American Ultraviolet. After the shipping cost, they cost me about $50 for 10 of them. They are commonly used in the food packaging industry, and they come with some simple directions. While the dosimeter cards don't have a specific dose listed for COVID-19, we have some data from the CDC to help with that. We'll get into that later. To determine what output we are getting from our UV light box, we will put in a dosimeter card and run the light box until our dosimeter card is fully exposed. We saw full exposure of the dosimeter card in a little under 30 seconds with the card facing up towards the light. And with the card facing the floor of the box, we were unable to get the card to full exposure. If your light box doesn't have a bulb on the bottom as well as the top, you will need to turn your item over one time for full disinfecting. The dosimeter cards start yellow, they turn orange when they've received a 50 dose, and when they turn pink, they have received a 100 dose. Now that we know we have an exposure quantity of 100 millijoules per square centimeter, we are able to calculate our exposure to meet the exposure suggested by the CDC. The CDC and the IUVA suggest 1,000 to 3,000 millijoules per square centimeter for COVID-19 deactivation. A little math shows us that with this UV setup, we are able to work with exposure times between 5 and 15 minutes per side to meet the CDC suggested exposure. Remember, per side if you only have a light on top like ours. And be sure to put your item directly under the light bulb as much as possible to get the best UV exposure. After the exposure time, turn the item over and give it the same dose on the other side. And don't forget that UV light is harmful to your eyes and skin. Be sure to avoid unwanted exposure. We hope this video is helpful in deciding whether UV light for sanitizing your stuff is something you want to try. Be sure to like and subscribe. We'll see you on the next video.